God bless you. Amen. Blessed day in the Lord. I'm just excited about who God is in my life. I'm excited about what he's doing. Great time in the park. God bless you, Sister Yafet. I enjoyed ourselves in the park. I got some amen with horns today, praise God. Pastors that are, amen, doing parking lot ministries. God bless you, Mother Crosby. God bless you, Sister Mays. Amen, as you're coming on. God bless you, Sister Margaret. I enjoyed our fellowship this morning and this afternoon, praise God, at 1. Amen. My amens was horn pumping. I really enjoyed that. It was a real blessing, praise God. You know, I like my amens, and the horns blessed me today, praise God. People was blowing the horns to give me my amens when it was touching the green with me, when the word was touching them, amen. It was blessing their lives. So tonight, praise God, I ask, amen, if the word is touching you, praise God, and you're with me, amen, just give me a like, amen, or a heart or something, praise God. Amen. Amen, Sister T. Whose report do you believe? Amen. God bless you, Sister Flood. Amen. Amen. Whose report will you believe? Praise God. We know we must believe God's report. Amen. As I begin to been sharing, amen, a lot of people have been reaching out to us with a lot of things they're excited about. Amen. The Daniel fast. We've got people, amen, in Alaska, Colorado. We got people in Tennessee doing it with us. We got people in Alabama, some people in California. All are on the Daniel fast with us, and we're excited about that. Everybody across the country now is doing the Daniel fast, following us on this Facebook Live as we are constantly sharing a nugget each evening at 6:30 with you. And we're just excited, amen, about what God has given us. Amen. So look, as you came on, praise God, quite a few of us, if you would bless us by sharing it out to someone else, let us bless someone else with the word today. Amen. And we know the nugget today, amen, if you had an opportunity to go out on Facebook today, it came from Isaiah 54 and 10, and it says, through the mess. Amen. God, and it says, and I want to do a little further, I want to work with this a little bit. And it goes in a surge of anger, I hid my face from you for a moment. But with everlasting kindness I have compassion on you, said the Lord. You, your Redeemer, for to me this is the day of Noah, when I swore that the waters of Noah would never again cover the earth. So I have swore that I will not be angry with you or rebuke you. Though the mountains may be removed and the hills may be shaken, my love devotion will not depart from you, and my covenant of peace will not be broken, saith the Lord, who has compassion on you. This is a powerful lesson for each one of us to realize, praise God, amen, because it lets us know, amen, that God has compassion, amen, upon us, amen. No matter what it is, amen, God is saying right here that he would never destroy, amen, and his promise to us, amen, though the mountains may shake and though hills may be removed, though any of these things may happen, he will continue to be with us. So even through our mess, God has promised to always be with us. Amen. God has always been with us. He will not leave us nor forsake us. This is a promise, amen, we need to live on, because sometimes we have such mess in our lives and such things going on that it's kind of hard to even feel and see God. And it's important that we realize, praise God, that God is with us. And I begin to say, well, God, what scripture can I encourage them with? And it came to me with a couple of things. And I'm going to work on a couple of them. I see about 20 more people have came on. Would you please share it out? Amen. Let's bring some others in. Let's bless some others. Praise God. As we continue to teach this lesson. And I realized, praise God, telling me that the mountains may be removed and hills may shake, but my love and devotion will never depart. That's powerful all by itself, that God said he will never, absolutely never, amen, amen, depart his love for us. Amen. So we see here, praise God, this is kind of compassion and love that God has for us. But I went to find, praise God, somewhere we can see when we're going through sometimes. It's hard for us to see that. And we look and see David, amen. We find David. David was a faithful man to God. We know as a young lad, David, a young son, David was great and faithful to God. We know that he did great things just with his hands. Amen. How many of you know this story? We know the story of David, amen, the way he was able to kill a lion with his bare hands. He was able to kill a bear with his bare hands. He was one, amen, with faith, live by faith, amen. He was one, praise God, that had a heart of God, amen. We know that he even was able to kill a giant, amen, amen, using a slingshot to knock him out and then use his own sword to kill him. We remember we talked about that last week, amen. So we know, praise God, that David was one, amen, with God's own heart. But it was a time in David's life, praise God, that David was at a point that he was needed blessing through his mess. He was in, amen, through the mess, he could not see God. It was so much going on, amen, in his life, amen. And so much was he was dealing with that he even wrote some psalms. Now, you know the amazing part about psalms? They actually are supposed to be psalms that you would sing. And this one in Psalms 22, amen, the first few verses said, my God, why have thou abandoned me? Why are you so far away from me? My groans for my help. Every day I call you, my God, but you do not answer. Every night I lift up my voice, but I hear have no relief. Here David is crying out to God. Mind you, once again, I tell you, this is the man that, amen, was able to kill a bear with his bare hands. He had been a warrior for God. He had been one, praise God, that God had been, he had been great in every way. But here we hear him crying out saying, God, you've forgotten all about me. Amen. It's so much mess going on that he don't see God. But here we find, praise God, God saying in Isaiah that my compassion, no matter whether the mountains be moved, no matter, praise God, if hills be shaken, I am with you. But we find David is saying, God, where are you? And this is when we're in our mess, we find ourselves sometimes wanting to know where you are. But I come to tell you the promises that he said, I'm with you. Somebody say amen to me. God is with you no matter how bad and how ugly it looks. No matter what happens, no matter what it is, you still can be encouraged. You know, I looked at this thing, praise God, and I see David, and sometimes the devil wants you to do this. How about this? You know what the devil wants you to do? I want to give you this. The devil wants you to get so discouraged and so upset. Watch this. Listen to this. Check this out. He wants you to get so mad and so upset because you're in so much mess and you don't see God. You know what he wants you to do? Stop praying. He wants you to stop praying and stop trusting God. But I come to tell you tonight, you keep praying. You keep trusting God, praise God, even in your mess. Because I gave you, praise God, in Isaiah tonight. I don't care how the mountains look. I don't care how bad your mess is. God say, I still love you. I still got your back. No matter how it is, and we just got to trust God. Now, we see that David says this, but guess what? In the 23rd Psalm, come on, somebody, come on. Now, in the 22nd Psalm, he's crying like this. 22nd Psalm, David is at a point that it doesn't look like nothing's going to go well for David. Don't look like there's no way out for my boy David. It just looks like David is not going to make it. Can I get an amen? It looks like David needs all the help he can get, don't it? Where you at, God? Look, where you at? I'm crying out to you, but you're nowhere to be found. Nowhere to be found. You can't help me in no way. But look what he says in the next song. Help me, somebody. He said, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. How quick does that turn around? How many of you know what I'm talking about? He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Now, look at how powerful God is. Now, in the 22nd Psalm, he said, God, I can't feel you. I don't know where you are. My enemy's overtaking me. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm in my mess, praise God. Bless me through my mess. But here we find, praise God, in the 23rd Psalm, he said, the Lord is my shepherd. See, God will bring you out if you hold on to his unchanging hands. Somebody give me amen out there. You need to understand the promises of God. No matter how bad the mess is, God is still in control. Somebody say amen to me. Somebody please say amen. Because we have got to know, praise God, that God is still moving no matter how it looks. God bless you, amen. God bless you there, my Bishop Butler. I love to see you out there. God bless each one of you, amen. Bilingual ministry, praise God. God bless you. Now share it out to the others, amen. I see quite a few of us out there, amen. Share it to the other saints. So we see there, praise God. Now mind you, 22nd Psalm,
David looks like nothing's ever going to go well for him. He's crying out to the Lord, saying that there's no way he can make it. He said, my God, why have thou forsaken me? Well, whether you know it or not, that's the same thing Jesus said on the cross. Do we remember? Jesus said, my God, why have thou forsaken me? We find it here, praise God, first heard in Psalms 22, where David is crying. Now, mind you, remember, David was a powerful man that trusts God to kill a bear with his hands. Oh, my God. But right here, we find David crying. And if you read on, praise God, in that song, David is really, really, really asking God for deliverance, his enemy. And he's saying that my enemy just all over me. My enemy is just taking control over me. But then in the 23rd song, he comes back, and everybody knows the 23rd song. We learned that as a kid. The Lord is my shepherd. Oh my God. But he maketh me to lie down. And remember my favorite, praise God. Anybody know my favorite? He prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemy. And you know, I really preached on that thing. Are you ready for your table? Amen. How many of you ready for your table, praise God? Because, amen. Come on, anybody know what that is? I see a lot of y'all put that out on your Facebook page. You should have put that out there with a question mark and ask your friends out there to ask you, your friends on Facebook should have asked you, well, what do you mean? See if they're ready for that table. Because the reason God has given some of us our table, because we ain't ready for him to prepare it in the presence of our enemies. I know you think you're ready, but God hasn't did it because you aren't ready, praise God. So, amen. There we show that God can work. Now, but I want to show you another thing God been working with me on. Because, amen, he says that he'll be there for us. And we see, praise God, that we go through these struggles. And we know that, praise God, no matter how it is, we got to continue to pray. We got to continue to stay steadfast. We can't let the enemy make us stay out of fellowship with God. No matter how bad it is, no matter how disappointed it is, somebody say amen to me. We have got to stay in fellowship with God. Somebody say amen to me. No matter how bad it is, amen, no matter how difficult, no matter how many people know your business, you still got to stay in fellowship with God. You know one thing I learned? When people know my business and I'm with God, it gets me more excited because that tells me right away that God's going to show up. You know why? Because God is surely, he's going to make sure his son is going to be taken care of. He's never going to let me be embarrassed because I'm his child. Amen, someone. All right, so praise God. With that being said, amen, I looked at this and I began to look at this and I'm saying, you know, God, all of us go through these things. All of us have these trials. All of us go through these situations. And we get to those dark days and those dark times, amen, when it looks like there's nobody else with us. And we feel that way, praise God. We feel like David feel. Though we know, amen, that promise is that the mountains be removed and the mountains may shake, amen, and the hills may shake. You still say you're devoted and you love me and you'll protect me. But God, sometimes I'm like David in the 22nd Psalm. I don't feel you. I'm in some mess and I don't feel you, praise God. And I feel like you've left me. But I went, praise God, a little further and I began to look in 1 Samuel. And this one blessed my soul so much. And I preached this one time in our congregation, amen, at the church. And I want to bring us to it in 1 Samuel, the 20th chapter, because it fits, amen. Because sometimes, amen, the enemy make you blame God on some stuff. Somebody say amen. Will help me. I know sometimes I said, God, just like David, come on. David said, well, where are you, Lord? If you read some of the songs, David went through a time, praise God. One of the Psalms, he said, God, where are you? The next Psalm, he encouraged and said, God can do it. The next Psalm, he's celebrating how God has blotted him out. And the next Psalm, he's saying, God, where you at? So if every third Psalm, he was asking God to help him. Some of us sometimes feel that God has dropped us. Come on, someone. Talk to me. Amen. So we find, praise God, in I ain't getting no amens in there, but somebody talk to the preacher today. Sometimes we feel that God has not taken care of us. We've asked him. We waited on him. We're sitting there. We've been faithful. We've done all we know to do, and we were waiting on God, and it looked like God hadn't showed up, and we get so disappointed. That's what the devil wants us to do, think that God has forgotten about us. Somebody say amen. So praise God, we find in 1 Samuel, praise God, the 20th chapter. Here we find now David sitting on the throne. David is blessed. David now, praise God, has gotten to a point, amen. He's gone through Psalms 22, amen. God has gave him victory over that. Saul, amen, now is dead. Jonathan, amen, and now is dead. Now, you know, Jonathan was his friend. That was Saul's son, amen. And David was very covenant brothers, amen, in their brotherhood. They would just love each other so well. But this was Saul's son. We know that Saul was the one running after David, the one that wanted David's life. And we find, praise God, amen, at this point, that David, amen, was on the throne. And he began to remember how he had made a covenant and a promise unto Jonathan. He said unto Jonathan that he would bless his family. And he began to ask if there was anybody left, amen, in the house of Saul. Was there anybody that he could bless other lineage of Jonathan, amen, that he could be a blessing? And one came to him and told him, praise God, that there was one, amen, by the that was the son of Jonathan that was in a place called Lodabar. Oh my God. Now, Lodabar was a place of nowhere. It was a place of mess. It was a place of nothing. It was a place you didn't want to be known from. It was a place that anybody else would be embarrassed to be called from. Amen. It was a terrible place to be known to be from. Now, mind you, Jonathan's son initially was living in the king's castle, but here we find that he's in Lodabar because his daddy, amen, at the time that when his daddy and his granddaddy Saul died, they ran away with him, praise God, and that's where he wind up at. And that's when David became king over the children of Israel. Can I get an amen? Somebody say, I know the story. And at this time, praise God, when they left, amen, with this baby in his hand, he was just a young lad, they dropped him and he became crippled. And when he became crippled, saints of God, he wind up in Lodabar and crippled. But David wanted to bless, praise God, somebody from the house of Jonathan. He wanted to be favored unto them. And so he asked, amen, of his men, amen, who in the house of Jonathan, who was from the house of Saul that he could bless. And they told him, praise God, that there was a son of Jonathan down in Lodabar. My God, in the place that nobody wanted to be from, in a place of where everybody was embarrassed to be called from, in a place that was considered nowhere. And he said, go get him. And when they went and got him, amen, this young man was so downtrodden in his spirit. He was so messed up, amen, feeling like everything was messed up about him, that he came to David and said, what do you want with a no good dog like me? See, sometimes the devil can get you so messed up to make you think you nothing at all and make you feel like everybody's against you, make you feel like the world, amen, God doesn't care anything about you. The devil will make you think God doesn't even care. And you know what God told me to tell you out of all I just said? He wanted me to let you know that he didn't drop you. No, no, no. See, some of you think the devil wants you to think that the God dropped you. Amen. No, he wasn't the one that dropped you. He's the one that's going to pick you up. Amen. I don't know what dropped you. I don't know what happened in your life. I don't know what caused you to get all messed up. I don't know what knocked your self-esteem down. I don't know what killed you. But God said, my compassion and devotion is with you always. My promise is I'm with you. I didn't drop you. I'm here to pick you up, to encourage you, and to bless your life. Can I get an amen out there? Somebody said, God didn't drop me. No matter what mess I'm in, no matter how mess it is, I'm going to bless you through it. I am. Oh, somebody give me an amen in there. It blessed my life to know that no matter how bad it is, God didn't drop me. Though it may look like it, he didn't drop me. He's there with me. He's going to bless me through the mess. Somebody say amen to me. Hallelujah. So no matter how bad it is, no matter how difficult it looks, you just hold on to God and watch God move for you. That this season, praise God, we got to know that God is with us. No matter how bad the mess is, no matter how much the devil thinks he's winning, no matter how evil and ugly it looks out there, no matter if they lock us down tomorrow, if they said nobody can go out of their house, amen, and you won't be able to pay your bills, God is not the one that's going to drop you. He is going to pick you up. Somebody celebrate God out there. So another promise is that God would never leave you nor forsake you. So once again, he says, even if the mountains, listen, the mountains, praise God, will be removed and the hills shall shake, I'm still with you, praise God. So he said, no matter how messed up, no matter how bad things is, I still got your back. Somebody celebrate God for having your back when everybody else, I don't care if everybody else quit on you. God said, I've still got your back. So, amen, don't worry. I don't care how, look, some of y'all got some messed up stuff that think God dropped you and forgot about you. He didn't drop you. He get ready to pick you up. After this message, after this, no, God's going to pick you up, somebody. You need to put out your Facebook, God didn't drop you. God is not the one to drop you. God is always the one to pick you up. And we love that, praise God. God is here with us, amen. God is the one to keep us. God bless you, Brother Mike, amen. All the way up there in the country. Praise God, he done moved to another state. We're glad to see you coming up, amen. But God, amen, did not drop you. He's there for us. Our promise is that he would always love us and be with us no matter what. And we need to be encouraged on that, praise God, because some of us do have mess in our lives, do have stuff that we seem to need, not be able to get out of, and it looks like God has dropped us and forgot all about us. But God told me to tell you today, he has not dropped you, praise God. He has your back. He will pick you up. Don't matter how bad it looks for you, he's got you. Somebody say amen to me. So praise God, amen. We had a great time in the park today. I love, amen, seeing all of you, praise God, those that sit in the car, amen. It's just a blessed time when we can get together like that. I'm so glad that, praise God, God can bless us through our mess. And the thing is, things of God, I don't care how messed up it is, God still can fix it. How many know what I'm talking about? Somebody say amen to me. Because I was in a terrible mess. Anybody else was in just, let's be honest, somebody blow it up. Anybody else was in a mess besides me, and God showed up and fixed it? Anybody else, amen, didn't know their way out? And the thing that really blew my mind, saints of God, is how he did it. God blessed me in a way that I never expected. See, I went to bed with all that stuff on my mind. It was a terrible mess. But it seemed like the next day, God seemed to clear it all up. I don't know how and what, but he seemed to fix it like in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. And you know, and I went to bed thinking he dropped me. But I woke up knowing that he lifted me up. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. And we got to continue to realize that's the kind of God we serve. Though, praise God, as it says in Isaiah, praise God, though, praise God, the mountains be removed, and though, praise God, the hills may shake, he is with us no matter what. No matter what kind of mess, no matter what kind of situation is, and he wanted me to tell you he did not drop you. Now give the God the hand clap of praise tonight. Now, amen, as we prepare to pray, praise God, we want to pray God to continue to bless, amen. We know Pastor Gunn, own Reverend Gunn's daughter, amen, has been going through the coronavirus herself. Amen. We've been notified that Brother Gunn is a very close friend of mine, praise God. We know for a fact she's been dealing with it in the Atlanta area. And we decree right now, we're going to pray, intercede for that brother. Amen. He's a brother in the gospel with us. Amen. We want all of us to stay safe. We know his daughter is dealing directly with this. Amen. Well, we decree, praise God, that she's going to come out better than she went in. Somebody say amen. Praise God. We decree, praise God, that he be at peace. Amen. Why? I know he's concerned about his child. Amen. My children are out of the state. Amen. I'm covering them. Amen. And praying for them. Amen. They got one of my children locked down in Charlotte starting this week. Amen. And the other ones in Raleigh, two in Charlotte. Amen. So I'm praying and asking God to cover them. We don't know what day they may lock us down here in the faith state of Virginia. Brother Mike, amen. He's locked down in his state. Amen. People in Alaska, we don't know when they're going to lock them all down. Praise God. So we just have to be, amen, careful. West Virginia, amen, they were locked down. I talked to somebody today there, amen. So all these different states, amen, are being locked down. Amen, Alabama, praise God. Somebody just telling me, amen, that they're locked down. So we got these different states, praise God, locked down, amen. But we know God still got in control. Amen. And while we're locked down, we still going to be praising God. We're going to be praising God right here every time we get a chance. Every time we go right here, we're going to lift the Lord up. We're going to work on these promises ever before. Is that all right? So let's touch and agree, amen, with the purpose, amen, to know that God, amen, did not drop you. God didn't drop you, no matter how many times the devil told you God's forgotten about you, because the enemy come against you to make you think that God's forgotten about you, but the devil is a lie. I know you waited for your prayer. I know you interceded and asked God to do it for you, and it still haven't showed up. That doesn't mean God's forgotten about you. He's dispatched the angel. I told you, amen, delayed, but on his way. I told you that, amen, about early last week. I think it was last week or week before last. I told you, delayed, but on his way. You've got to decree in your spirit that, praise God, though it's not here, it doesn't tarry long. If you just trust and hold on to God and believe that God can do it, he can do it. Somebody say amen. God is waiting on some of us to believe he can do it so he can do it. Can I get an amen in here? Somebody said, praise God, God's waiting on me to just trust on him. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. So get out of your resources and watch God use his resources. So we're grateful to each one of you. Praise God. Oh, praise God. I don't see Pastor Stuart Jones. Praise God. Pastor, amen, the new pastor of Fifth Street Baptist. We thank God. Amen. Looking forward to working with you. Congratulations, my brother, has been appointed as pastor there. I'm excited. Amen. They picked a great choice. Amen. We're looking forward to working with you, brother. We're right down the street from you. So we're excited about that. Amen. Bishop Butler, we work hand in hand. Mother Krause, thank you for being there. Amen. I pray all of you sharing this out to others. Amen. Let us go before the Lord in prayer right now. Amen. Believe in God. Let's first of all touch and agree for our own brother Gunn's daughter, Reverend Gunn's daughter. Heavenly Father, God, we speak right now that, God, we already know there's been dispatched angels towards her bedside. We already know, God, that you already in the control. So, God, we really come to just praise you for the results. We come to already praise you for what you're going to do. We already know, God, you already got everything under control. That's prayers already been dispatched that way. Angels already at her bedside. Things already improving. We already realize, God, everything's under control. We know, God, that that's a man of faith, God. One that trusts in you and believes in you. The mother that believes in you and trusts in you. We ask, God, you can just continue to build them up, God, knowing that you're the author and the finish of it all. And God, in the name of Jesus, now bless that daughter, God, while she lays in the hospital bed, God, that every nurse should come in know that she's a chosen child. Lord, let them see, God, and not only that, bless every nurse and doctor that walks into the room. Let them be blessed by being by her bedside. Let their lives be blessed. Let their children be blessed. Let this be a generational blessing unto all of them that have a blessing by being able to take care of her. I speak, God, your total healing power upon her, and not only her, God, but everyone now, God, in the name of Jesus, that have got this disease. We speak against it right now, God, and we ask that you take it out of their lives. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we know you can heal because you healed me from cancer. You raised my mother from dead. I've seen you heal tuberculosis, diabetes. I've seen you heal cancer. I've seen you heal all. I've seen you move tumors. I've seen you, God, take brain cancer out. I've seen you give sight to the blind. I've seen you seen people get up and walk. I've seen it with my own eyes, God. I've seen people that couldn't hear. I've seen people that couldn't talk. I've seen things, God, that I could see people, God, that everybody, I see my daughter that said, well, go home on a respirator for the rest of her life, pull it out herself and begin to breathe, and has never been on a respirator a day in her life. You can do all things but fail, God. So I decree right now, God, that you move by your power upon this nation, God, upon this world. God, let them know who you are. Send a revival, God. Heal the people right now in the name of Jesus. Let your power and your anointing, your authority, come on, someone. For what we know of you, come on, somebody. We know you are a healer. We know you can do these things. And we speak it into the atmosphere right now. The heal, God, move by your power upon everyone that is sick, everyone that don't even know they have the disease right now. Shield them, God, not to give it to anyone else, God. In the name of Jesus, keep us protected. Keep our God, for our house is covered under the blood. God, in the name of Jesus, we ask that you favor our houses. Every one of our houses, God, as we have to go in and out, we speak for your promises. We speak for your glory and your blessings upon each one of us in the name of Jesus. Have your way. Come on, somebody. Have your way with us, God. Keep us upon your glory. Let our light shine, for the world needs to see us now, God, as ever before. Now, bless, God, in the name of Jesus. We ask that you continue to bless the elderly, God, as they're in their homes, God. Some of them are isolated, God, not seeing loved ones, God. They're feeling lonely, but send an angel, God. Send comfort into their homes, God. Show them your love in special ways in the name of Jesus. Just have your ways upon them, God, as they sit there, God, as they're lonely, God. Make sure you manifest your ways into their lives. Send the food by, God, whatever it needed for them. Provide for them, God, upon every family, God. Bless in the name of Jesus those that are concerned about their welfare, God. Let them believe your report, God. Your report is that you will do what you say you'll do. You will do your promise as ever before, God. You will go on to live 100%, and we shall not lack anything. So bless in the name of Jesus upon every family, God. We decree it, God, right now in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, we speak right now. We speak into the atmosphere that you'll bless this nation. Bless our leaders in this nation. Bless everything, God, that goes according to your plan. Now, in the name of Jesus, we claim it. We claim it as to be so. Come on, someone. We claim, God, that you did not drop us. Come on, someone. You didn't drop me, God. Somehow didn't drop me, God. You come to lift me up. You come to bless my life. You come to protect me and be with me. So, God, in the name of Jesus, as we touch and agree in the atmosphere, come on, someone, that all these things we pray tonight shall come to pass. Be with each one of us. Keep us strong before you, God. In the precious anointed name of Jesus, we do pray. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Amen and amen. Now listen, praise God. Look for the nugget, amen, for tomorrow morning. Amen. We're going to start with the 30 days to be a better you. Come on, saints. Somebody know we love that 30 days to be a better you. 100%. We're working 100%. That means all of April, we're going to read a scripture every day. We're going to study that scripture. Praise God. We got to focus. We're going to be doing some different things. We're still in the Daniel fast. It's our ninth day. Amen. We can continue. I hear the neighbor. Praise God. I see they came up. Amen. We hear the neighbor. Amen. They brought all this pizza home. Amen. Hey, you want some pizza? They was going into the garage. I told them I was going to tell on them and offer me some pizza. I said, you know I'm on a Daniel fast, but I thank them for being such a blessed and kind neighbor. But I told them I was going to snitch on them tonight. I love each one of you. Praise God. Let's stay encouraged with each other. Stay strong. Stay faithful. Keep reading your word. Amen. Keep standing before the Lord. Study his promises. Know that the promise means something to you. Write one on your, and put one on your refrigerator. Put one on your mirror, in your bathroom, praise God, wherever you need to get that encouraging word and know that you live 100%, that God can have his way. God did not drop you. I love you, and God knows I do, and there's absolutely not a thing you can do about it. Be blessed. See you tomorrow.